Hi, hello, namaste. Welcome back to Needs of Children. We are discussing about 9th standard English medium social science in that geography chapter number 5 continued part of land resources of Karnataka. In the previous session, we get the information about agriculture and the types of cultivation in Karnataka. Let's come to the In this session, we are going to get the more information about the land resources of Karnataka. The major crops of Karnataka. Just like different types of farming, there are different types of crops in Karnataka. The main responsible for this are soil, climatic conditions, relief features, irrigation facility, traditions of the farmers and market for the agricultural produce, etc. are playing a very important role. So the crops of Karnataka can be classified as food crops like paddy, ragi, maize, pulses, millets. Commercial crops like sugarcane, cotton, tobacco, mulberry. Whereas oil seeds like groundnut, ginseng seed, sesame, sunflower, etc. Whereas plantation crops like coffee, coconut, reka nut, rubber, banana, etc. In addition to these, different types of horticultural crops and floriculture are there. So now let us study about the major crops of Karnataka. Among that, the major food crops, so like paddy. Paddy is a very important food crop of our Karnataka. Majorly, rice is a staple food of the people of Karnataka. Paddy is grown in 28.2% of the total cultivatable land. Even irrigation facility, use of chemical fertilizers and high yielding hybrid seeds have resulted improvement in the yield of paddy. Paddy is a tropical crop. Cultivation of paddy requires heavy rainfall and high temperature. Areas having scanty rainfall need irrigation facility for the growing of paddy. So where very less rainfall, in that area needs to be the irrigation facility. Cultivation of paddy requires the land should be level. Fertile clay and alluvial soils are ideal for paddy cultivation. Whereas organic manure, leaves of trees and abundant laborers are required for the cultivation of paddy. Nearly 70% of paddy sown during June to August months and harvested in the month of November and December. Majorly, it is a kharif crop. Kharif crop, nothing but it is called as the rain-fed crop. So as even in summer, paddy is grown in the areas where irrigation facility is available during the time of February to June. In that time, it is called as the rabi crop. When it is the rainy season crop, it is called as kharif crop. When it is summer crop, it is called as rabi crop. And in Malnad, the paddy is grown by broadcasting method. So here, it is an example for the broadcasting method. You can see here it is an example for the broadcasting method. And in the plains by transplanting method. So here it is an example for the transplanting method. So these are the two methods they are using for the growing of paddy in Malnad region. So where are the paddy growing areas? Paddy is grown in all the districts of Karnataka, like the Krishna,
Tungabhadra Valley, Kaveri Valley and the coastal districts are famous for paddy cultivation. Even Raichur district stands first in the production of paddy in our Karnataka. So followed by Bellary, Shivamogga, Davanagere, Mysuru, Mandya, Koppal, Uttara Kannada, Udupi, Dakshina Kannada and Kalburgi district. Whereas the other paddy growing areas of Karnataka are Tumakuru, Hasan, Chikkamagaluru, Kodagu and Belagavi district. The yield and quality of paddy is better in irrigated areas. So where it is growing with the help of irrigation facility, that irrigated areas paddy, the quality and yield is better. So that is the information of paddy. Let's move on to the second major food crop of our Karnataka, that is Jowar. So this is the second most important crop in Karnataka after paddy. Until recently, the area under Jowar cultivation was more than that paddy. But recent years, it has decreased. The total area under Jowar cultivation is 26% of the cultivatable area. Karnataka ranks after Maharashtra in the production of Jowar in India. So Maharashtra stands in the first place in the production of Jowar, whereas Karnataka stands in the second place. Whereas Jowar is the staple food of the people of North Karnataka, it is mainly used for preparing rotis. The stalks of Jowar plant are used as cattle fodder. South Karnataka, Jowar is primarily grown for the purpose of cattle feed. So this crop is also belongs to the grass family. This crop also belongs to the grass family. Its botanical name is called as Sorghum vulgare. Sorghum vulgare is the botanical name of Jowar. It is a tropical crop requiring moderate rainfall and moderate temperature. Mixed black and red soil and alluvial soil are suitable for Jowar. It is a rain-fed crop and grown by using broadcasting method. So majorly it is depends upon the southwest monsoons. So let's come to the Jowar. So the growing areas, except for a few districts of our South Karnataka, all other districts grow Jowar. So very importantly, Vijayapura, Kalaburgi, Bagalkot, Raichur, Belagavi, Bidar, Bellary, Davanagere, Koppal and Gadag are the leading producers of Jowar. Among these, Vijayapura stands first in the production of Jowar in our Karnataka. Chitradurga, Shivamogga, Chamarajanagar, Hasan, Tumkur, Mandya districts are also producing Jowar. So these are the growing areas of Jowar. So that is about the information of Jowar. Let's move on to the third important major crop of our Karnataka, that is Ragi. So Ragi is a very nutritive food grain. Its botanical name is Elasaina coracaena. Is the botanical name ragi balls, porridge, spalted flour, malt, dosa, etc. are made from ragi. So whereas in Karnataka, it is the third most important food grain after paddy and Jowar. So it is a cheap grain, but nowadays it's gets lot of importance. The stalks of the ragi plant are used as a fodder for cattle. Ragi can be preserved for many months. Whereas ragi is a tropical crop. High temperature, moderate rainfall, red sandy and loamy soils are suitable for this crop. It can be withstand very severe droughts. In some places, ragi is grown by using irrigation facility. Whereas many laborers are needed to transplant ragi saplings. Pull out the weeds to harvest and store ragi. It is a very important kharif crop. So it can be grown even during the summer season by using irrigation. So let's move on to which are the very important growing areas of ragi. Karnataka stands first in the production of ragi in India. However, the use of ragi has reduced. Ragi is grown in 14% of the total cultivatable land. The ragi growing areas are concentrated in the districts of Southern Maidan. So most probably Southern Maidan districts are concentrated in Karnataka. So like ragi is a traditional crop of old Mysuru province. Jowar is the main crop in North Karnataka, whereas ragi is the main crop in South Karnataka. Tumkuru is the leading producer of ragi. So then comes Ramnagar, Bengaluru rural, Hasan, Mandya, Kolar, Chikkaballapur, Shivamugga, Chikkamagaluru, Chamarajanagar and Davanagere districts are the producers of ragi, growing areas of ragi. So that is the information about the ragi. So that's it about the today's session. I hope you have understood the concepts. Till now we are discussed about the major crops of our Karnataka. So in case if you having any doubts related to till now what we are discussed, you can comment in the comment box. I will solve your doubts and I will come back with the next video. Until, keep watching my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you in the next session. Bye bye. Take care.